On the double! On the double! Do you know how to defend yourself and your business against the dangers of using non-conforming materials?
Don't apologize to me and refer to me always as Sergeant, do you understand?
Sergeant!
Oh, a lot louder!
Sergeant!
A lot shaggy louder!
In this video on positive material identification for metals, we'll teach you how to neutralize threats to your critical material supply chain. Ten hut! Today we're going to cover two topics. First, why do you need to work with a manufacturer that performs PMI? And second, we'll show you some of the machines used to perform such a task. It's time once again for Serious Engineering for Serious Engineers. First order of business, why do you need to work with a manufacturing partner that performs PMI? And what are they testing for? There are four reasons. Learn them fast, learn them well. Number one. There are hundreds of unique metal alloys on the market with only slight differences between them. Nevertheless, even small differences can have a big effect on how a metal is processed and how it performs. Lesson: always verify your material against a reference standard using a scientific instrument, and then calibrate your CNC machine speeds and feeds according to that exact material. Number two, hot rolling, cold rolling, drop forging, oil quenching, shot peening, all these treatments and more affect the metallurgical properties, even if the internal makeup is the same. Lesson: use PMI, including hardness testing, to verify how your metal was post-treated. Number three, the chain of custody, or CFC, can be complex, as materials pass through many hands, from the raw ore ripped out of the guts of the earth, all the way to heavy metal slabs lying in a warehouse. Beware. Unscrupulous dealers may try to pass along the wrong material and make you pay for it. Lesson: I pity the fool who only believes what the paper trail says. Verify with PMI. Oh, I like the sound of that. Verify with PMI, verify with PMI. Ooh, that's good. I'm keeping that one. Number four, using non-conforming material, even unknowingly, can put lives at risk and jeopardize large, complex construction projects. It can also involve you and your company in serious criminal penalties. Lesson: you are ultimately responsible for protecting your business and your reputation. Insist on working only with qualified supply chains. If they can't prove it, it's time to move it. To purge non-conforming metals from your supply chain, we need some powerful weapons. First up, the Hitachi XMET 8000. This little beauty is military spec tough. So we use it in the lab and the field. It's our daily go-to for quick, reliable XRF analysis of metal stock. Let's blast a few samples and make them talk. Did you get that, maggots? Didn't even leave a scratch. The XRF gun can be used to test for banned substances like cadmium, lead, or mercury. But XRF guns like this have a limited range. That's why we need to program it in advance and tell it what type of material we're testing for. That way, it can give a more accurate reading within that range. To test for different levels of carbon content in steel, we need a bigger gun. Say hello to my little friend. This here is the Oxford Instruments Optical Emission Spectrometer, or OES. This baby uses a powerful electric spark to vaporize the metal and force it to give off a spectral signature which is unique for every element. The resulting spectra passes through a gradient filter where it's analyzed and compared to an onboard database. The OES tells you the relative concentration of the elements in your sample, and that's important for determining the grade of stainless steel that you're working with. And why is that important? Because the carbon content determines how corrosion resistant your alloy is, whether it's free machining, if it can be welded, or even 3D metal printed. As you can see, the OES does leave a scorch mark, what we call a spark site, on the test sample, so we use it to test raw stock or an inconspicuous area of a finished part. Okay, you slugs, there you have it. Positive material testing for metals. Have you learned your lesson? Don't cut corners, don't take chances, don't trust the paper trail. Only work with suppliers that can guarantee 100% PMI for all raw materials that they use to make your parts and tools. Okay, you know what to do. Hit that bell, hit the like button, subscribe and share, or I'll make you drop and give me 25. And that was serious engineering for serious maggots. Are you listening to me, son? I'm asking you, are you, don't look down there, look up here. Are you listening to me, son? I'm sorry, am I boring you, son? Oh, well, thank you very much for joining us, lovely boy. Well, I'm so glad you could join us. Did we wake you up? I'm sorry, did we get you out of bed? Come along, maggots, where are you? Tan Hut!